Hello friends, welcome to my class. Now I am going to explain the properties of the vector product or cross product. Okay, in the last class we have seen that cross product or vector product in detail by observing or by taking, by considering some what, how and why. I hope you understand that cross product according to these steps or points. Okay, and now I would like to explain the properties according to the same points, that is what, how and why. So what is the property tells us? The property nothing but, do you know, property nothing but characteristics. What are the characteristics of the cross product or vector product? Okay, and how can we understand that, how many are their properties? Okay, that we are going to see. And why should we use these properties? If you see these properties, so that we can simply understand the problems. These properties will be used in the problem solving purpose. Now let us go through the one by one, and we already discussed this is the definition of the cross product, that is A bar cross B bar is equals to AB sin theta into n cap, where n cap is the unit vector which is normal to the A bar and B bar. Okay, and AB is the magnitudes of A bar and B bar. Sin theta is the function and which tells us the angle between the two vectors. Now in the beginning I would like to explain from the orthogonal vectors. There are many properties are there. Okay, I am going to explain only few properties, then we can, which are very useful for the problem solving purpose. Orthogonal vectors, to understand that, let us assume a three dimensional plane, that is x, y and z axis. Let us consider I cap along x axis, j cap along y axis, k cap along z axis. Okay, so these are the orthogonal vectors. Now for example, I am taking I cap here and j cap here equal to, instead of this A bar and B bar, A bar is a vector, B bar is a vector, and I bar or I cap is a unit vector, J cap also is a unit vectors which are in different directions. So I cap along x axis, J cap along y axis, normal to each other. Okay, and if you take this AB, AB nothing but magnitude of this A bar and B bar. Here I am taking magnitude of I cap is 1. Magnitude of J cap is 1, and sine, which are normal to each other, sine 90, and this is normal to this both vectors, and this k is a normal, k is a unit vector which is normal to this both I and J. I am writing it as k cap. So from that we can write this is 1 into 1 into k, so that we can write it as k from I cap cross J cap equal to k cap. Okay. Now from that we can write it, give from this expression we can understand there is a cyclic process, and this is I cap, and let us this is J cap and this is K cap. Okay, cyclic, I cap cross J cap giving K cap. Okay, I J gives K, I J giving K, and J cap cross J K gives what? J and K gives I cap. Okay. Next, K cap cross I cap. K cap cross I cap gives what? J cap. So these are the counterclockwise direction. Okay. When we are multiplying one vector with another vector, we must go through the counter clockwise direction, otherwise called anti-clockwise direction, to get the positive sign, to get the positive sign. And if you go through the clockwise direction like this, if you go through this direction, we will get negative vectors like, okay, I am just reversing this vector, that is J into I, nothing but J cap cross I cap gives what? Minus K cap. How? J I in a clockwise direction, which is opposite to the counter clockwise direction. J and I gives K. and this is k cap cross j cap gives minus I cap, and I cap cross k cap gives minus j caps. So these are the orthogonal unit vectors when the one vector is multiplied by the another vectors giving a normal vector, that is here k I j. This is normal to this both, and this is normal to this both vectors, and this is normal to this both vectors, and also in a one more direction if you take, then in a reverse direction if you take, we will get the negative vectors. So for example, if we multiply the same unit vectors like I cap cross I cap, what we will get? Okay, the magnitude is 1 and magnitude is 1, and sign, there is a same unit vectors along in the same direction, so that we can get it as sin 0 into, and which is normal to what? I, which is normal to, that may be j or k, yes or no. So even though sin 0 is total 0, no need to write j and k. So from that we can write it as I cap cross I cap is equals to j cap cross j cap, okay, equal to k cap cross k cap, always equal to 0. Whenever we get the like this I cap, j cap, cross k cap in the problems, we should take 0. Whenever nothing but while we are multiplying one vector with another vector, we have to multiply one vector with other vector, not with the same vectors. From that we can write it as, okay, a bar cross a bar always gives 0. This is very very important. The cross product of the same vectors gives 0 vector, gives 0 value. So this is the property orthogonal unit vectors. Now let us understand one by one. Okay, second one is commutative property. Commutative property. What is the commutative property? That is A bar cross B bar is equals to B bar cross A bar. So this is the actual commutative property. We need to check whether the cross product obeys this commutative law or not. Let us consider A bar is equals to 2 I cap, B bar is equals to 3 J cap. Okay, multiply here. A bar nothing but what? 2 I cap cross B bar nothing but 3 J cap is equals to B bar nothing but 3 J cap cross A bar nothing but 2 I cap. 2 3 is 6. Okay, I cap cross J cap here, and this is 3 2 is 6, J cap cross I cap, 6 into this is IJ, yes this is order, IJ gives K, okay, recently we have seen, and 6 into, okay, JI, okay, JI, see this is reverse order, so that we will get minus K cap. So from this it is not equal to 0. And then we can simply understand cross product or vector product does not obey the commutative law or commutative property. Okay, now let us see third one is distributive property. Distributive property. What is the distributive property? Distributive property. That is A bar cross of B bar plus C bar equal to A bar cross B bar plus A bar cross C bar. Okay. To check this, we need to consider some values, some vector. A bar is equals to 2 I cap, B bar is equals to 3 J cap, and C bar is equals to 4 K cap. Okay. So here A bar is equals to 2 I cap, nothing but there is no J vector, there is no value for J vector, there is no magnitude of K vector, here there is no magnitude of I vector and K vector, okay, these two are absent, here I, K K are absent, here I, J are absent. Okay, listen to me. Here I am writing, this is A bar. Okay, so before that we need to sum this. A plus B. A bar plus B bar, nothing but what? 2 plus, yes, 2i plus 0i, 2i only, plus 3j plus 0j, 3j only, plus 0k cap. Okay, next, and A bar nothing but what? Only 2i, okay, cross, this is 2i cap plus 3j cap is equals to, that is 2i cap cross 3j cap plus 2i cap cross c nothing but 4k cap. Okay, okay, I will solve the right side. This is 2 3s 6, ij always gives k, plus 2 4s 8, ik gives minus j, ki gives j, so that this is minus j. Now this is what? 2i plus 3j. Okay, how can we multiply this in the same order? Okay, 2 2 2 is 4, I cross I 0. Okay, 2 3 is 6, ij always gives k. Yes, it's not obeying, cross product does not obey the distributive law or distributive property, so that it does not obey, it's not equal. So this is total 0, 6k not equal to 6k cap minus j cap minus 8j cap. So this is a distributive property, and one more, that is fourth one, is associative property, that is also the cross product does not obey the associative property. Now let us see some problems on the cross product so that we can understand. For example, A bar is equals to 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap is there, and B bar is equals to 3i cap plus 4j cap plus 5k cap. Then what is the cross product of the two vectors? Okay, the cross product of the two vectors can be taken by taking the determinant of the two vectors. Okay, like this. Okay, I cap, j cap, k cap are the orthogonal vectors. I am writing this 2, 3, 4 are the magnitude of A vectors. Okay, I am writing 2, 3, 4 because this is a vector. And B vector, that is 3, 4 and 5. To find this determinant, we need to follow one rule. There are three steps are there. So first step to get this, to get the I cap vector, we need to cancel this, or we need to neglect this column, and also we need to neglect this row. Okay, and remaining values must be multiplied with each other, like 3 5s 15 minus 4 4s 16. Okay, and this must be positive, negative and positive, and this is minus j cap. Okay, and this must be cancelled. Okay, and this one is multiplied, must be multiplied. Okay, this is the row and this column must be neglect. This is 2 5 is a 10 minus 3 4 is a 12 plus k cap. Okay, now this must be, this column must be neglect and this row must be neglect, and this is this one and this one should be multiplied. 2 4 is a 8 minus 3 3 is a 9. So that is what? This is minus I cap. Okay, this is minus 2, minus minus, minus 2 to minus plus 2j cap. This is minus k cap. So this is the product of the vector product or cross product of the two vectors in the determinant form. This is a very shortcut method to find the answer. We can do normal method like a dot product, have you done, you know. So that is very difficult for this cross product. So this is a better way to get the answers in a shortcut method. This is known as the determinant method, determinant, or by taking mod on both sides, we call it determinant. So this is how we can simply understand the cross product, which will be very useful in the problem solving purpose. In the next class, let us see applications of the cross product. Thank you.